I've been happy with nothing. Imagine me if I got it. Say if my nine stop busting. Imagine me with a shot. I've been pushing this Pontiac. Imagine me in the robbery. Bumping God's whisper by robbery. Probably be with a shot.
Yo, what's good with the squad? It's Malik the God, and we back at it, man. Now, I know it's been a little minute, but I'm trying to get back into the grind of making these YouTube videos, and I'm finna start off with doing build videos. So if you have any NBA players you want me to make, drop it down low in the comments. I already got some ideas, but you know what I'm saying, I can always use more. But without further ado, let's get into this video. We got Zion Williamson, of course, power forward, left-handed, jersey number one. Now, I will say that you don't have to do any of this, like the name, the face scan, none of it. But if you do want to do it, I'm gonna have a link down in the comments for the face scan, and of course you see the name and everything right there. I'm trying to make the most realistic Zion as possible, and that's my goal here. Not to make the best build, not to make the most OP build or anything like that. I'm making Zion Williamson, you know what I'm saying? So let's go ahead and get into it. Now for the pie chart, I've seen a lot of people do it. I've seen the pure slasher. I've seen the playmaking slasher. I've seen the playmaking defender. But if I'm being honest, bro, I don't like any of those. Mostly because I don't like the playmaking pie chart being included, because it just gives him way too much playmaking, in my opinion. Even though it's like the playmaking defender is still a great build, it's not really Zion, in my opinion. Mostly because it doesn't get Hall of Fame finishing badges. And if you're Zion without Hall of Fame finishing badges, are you really Zion? You feel me? But anyways, let's go ahead and get into it. Now, the pie chart I'm going to use today is the finishing and defense pie chart. Finishing and defense pie chart, the blue and red. And I believe this is the best fit for Zion. It completely epitomizes everything that Zion does on the court. So we're gonna go with this one. Now for the physical, it's really up to you, but for the sake of this video, I'm going with the pie chart with the most vertical. I've made this build already, and I went with the speed pie chart, but that's just my personal preference. I don't really see much of a difference with the vertical, but for to make Zion, you want to have a really high vertical. So I'm going with the vertical pie chart on this one, which is the fourth one down. And now for the attributes, of course you want to max out your close shot, you want to max out your driving layup, and you also want to max out your driving dunk. Now for the standing dunk, this is more personal preference. Zion is a pretty good standing dunk guy, but he's not the greatest. Like, I've, you know, tweaked with this build, and 78 is a pretty good, what's the name, right here is where you get your 17th finishing badge, and that's pretty much all you really need on this build. But you could do a little bit better. So like I said, it's up to you. If you want to max it out, you can get up to I believe 19 finishing badges, but I just went ahead and said, you know what, let me just get, I can do with 17. For the shooting, you're gonna go ahead and max out your midi, you're gonna max out that three-point shot, you're gonna max out that free throw, and you're also gonna max out that post fade. Now I'm saying this because even though Zion is known for his driving and, you know, bullying people into the paint, he can also shoot the ball. Now he's not the greatest shooter, and these stats show that you're not gonna be the greatest shooter ever out on the court. But I will tell you, with this 53 point shot, this 65 midi, plus the shooting badges that you're getting, you're going to be able to shoot. I promise you'll be able to shoot. Don't even trip on it, right? Now, going on to the playmaking, this is up to you. First of all, you want to max out your ball handle. Post moves is not really needed. So like I said, it's up to you. You could even say fuck it and not put up your ball handle. It's really up to you. Considering, you know what I'm saying, like if you want to get you can get up to 3 playmaking badges without upgrading your post moves, and you're gonna need these upgrades for your defense next. So like I said, it's up to you. I personally would just go ahead and say forgive my pass accuracy, I'll be fine, just put my ball handle up, 1 playmaking badge will be all right. But it's like I said, it's up to you. This is me also making Zion, and like I said, he has a solid handle. He's not the greatest passer, and he doesn't use post moves a lot. Like, more than likely, he's going to bully you down in the paint more than he's going to put you in a post spin, or, you know what I'm saying? Exactly. So, into the defense, we're going to go ahead and max out our interior defense. We're going to max out our defensive rebound, our offensive rebound, and also our block. Those are the, you have to have those on this build if you want to be Zion. That's just period. Now we're going to get into the other ones. As for the steal, I say leave it alone. Me personally, I like I said, I have this build already, and then if I'm being real, if I'm being 100 with y'all, I don't need my steal upgrade. I get pokes period without my steal being up, so I don't think it's worth it. Also, I would like to, I'm going to tell y'all a little secret. I don't think pickpocket is a great badge. That's just my personal opinion, but I get pokes without it, so I don't think it's needed. But hey, that's for another video. The next 30, I would go ahead and max out my perimeter defense, or actually I would take it down to about a 70 perimeter defense, and then I'll put the rest into my lateral quickness. Now, like I said, you're not going to be the greatest on the perimeter, you're not going to be the greatest lateral quickness, but you'll be, if you know what you're doing, you can make up for it. And it's kind of like Zion. Zion's not the greatest perimeter defender, but in the paint, he's a god. You know what I'm saying? He's not going to lock you up on the perimeter like a Kawhi, but in the paint, he's going to shut that down. You know what I mean? So that's why I feel like this embodies Zion. From the dunking to the shooting to the playmaking and defense, you're going to be able to play like Zion. Now, if you look at the badge upgrades, you got 17 finishing, 7 shooting, which is going to be enough for you to hit at least in the corner if you do your badges right and you got a good jump shot. You only got 1 playmaking, which is probably the downfall of this build. If you want to go with 3, like I said, you probably take away your lateral quickness and perimeter defense and put up your pass accuracy, and you can get 3 playmaking, get quick first step. It's up to you. And you also get 20 defensive badges on this build. So now we're finna move on to the next one. As for body shape, I personally like built. You can also go burly for Zion, but I personally like built. I think it looks better, even though Zion is kind of like, he's in between. He's more burly than built, but I like built more. It looks more like Zion for me on the game. As for the height, you're gonna go 6'7". Now he is listed at 6'6", but that's without shoes. In the game, you're gonna wear shoes. You can't go lower than 6'6" as a power forward, 6'7" as a power forward. So 6'7" is where we're gonna go. And as you can see, your driving dunk goes up to a 92. Your driving layup goes up to an 82. Your ball handle goes up to a 70, which is just enough to get the pro dribble moves. So you're going to be able to, you know, sauce a little bit. And then, you know, everything else, your perimeter defense goes up, your lateral goes up a little bit. So everything is good. And then you look at your physicals, you get 83 speed on this build. Always think about speed as a +8, right? So 83 +8. I'm not exactly sure. I think that's 91 or 92, if I'm not mistaken. That's great. Now I'm saying +8 because of the training facility and because of, you know, hitting 99. Honestly, it could be a +9 if you get 99.9, but I don't know. I've never hit 99.9, but one time, and I don't remember. It was pretty hard to keep it at 99.9. I'm not gonna lie to you. So you want to just think about that, and also look at your vertical. You have a 90 vertical, so you're going to be flying. You're going to look exactly like Zion out there. Now for the weight, you're going to max the weight out, max it all the way out. Your interior defense goes up to an 82, which is perfect. You're going to be able to go up against bigger power forwards, bigger centers, and handle them. Like, I'm not going to say you're always going to be better than them, but You're going to win more than you lose, I promise you. Your vertical does go down to an 87, but like I said, with the +4 and, you know, +8, you're going to be flying. Your vertical, your strength goes up to a 77 as well, so you're pretty strong. You know what I'm saying? So yes, max out your weight. As for the wingspan, it's up to you. Now, Zion doesn't have a long wingspan, so I'm going to go with 84.7. It's just it's more than enough. It's one over the normal wingspan. And like I said, Zion doesn't have a long wingspan, so this is what I'm going with. And you can also keep your ball handle at a 70. So 84.7 is way to go. Now, if this was up to me, I probably wouldn't max it out and just wait until I'm a 97 to get my ball handle to 70. But for the sake of this video and being Zion, I'm going with 84.7. And now we have the takeover. Now, all of these are viable options, bro. Like, I'm not finna sit here and lie to you. All of these are very viable options. But come on now. Like, rim protector's cool. Like, yes, Zion is a great rim protector. He's a great glass cleaner. But if you're making a Zion build, your takeover has to be slasher. Like, it just does not make sense to do anything other than slasher. Just because you want to, like, come on. You want to be dunking people. That's what Zion is known for. He's known for the other two things too, but he's really known for dunking. So we're going with slasher on this. And as you can see, we have built a paint beast, and it's similar to none other than Zion Williamson. You know what I'm saying? So if you like the video, please drop a like, subscribe if you're new, man. I'm gonna start pumping out some more of these videos. So, you know, like I said, if you have any ideas for me, drop the request down in the comment section and let me know. And you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna mess with y'all. Y'all be easy. Deuces.